In previous learning modules, we've talked about positive series, where each term an is bigger or equal to zero. And we've devised a number of tests to see if those series converge. We have the integral test, if the terms are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. And we have the comparison test, and we have the limit comparison test. Now we're going to start talking about series where the terms aren't all positive. And we're going to start with alternating series, which is the nicest kind. So we'll say a series alternates if, as the name implies, the signs of its terms alternate. So you might have A1 positive and A2 negative and A3 positive and A4 negative and A5 positive and A6 negative, or the other way around. Either way, it's fine. But you have all the odd terms have one side sign and all the even terms have the opposite sign. So for example, you might look at what's called the alternating harmonic series. We already looked at 1 plus a half plus a third plus a fourth. Now let's look at 1 minus a half plus a third minus a fourth plus a fifth. That's an example of an alternating series. So is our old friend that diverges, where the terms get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And here's another one where the terms get bigger for a little while and then they get smaller again. So let's take a close look at this series and see what happens with it. So if you have that series, let's do our partial sums. We start off at 0 and then we add 1. So we go all the way up to 1. And then we subtract a half. And then we add a third. Adding a third to a half gives us 5/6. And then we subtract a quarter. And then we add a fifth. Gives us something a little bit over 3/4. And then we subtract a sixth. And then we add a seventh. And you see what's happening. Every tip of the green arrow is to the right of where it was before. So this is A1, A3, A5, sorry, S1, S3, S5, S7. They're getting smaller and smaller and smaller. But S2, S4, S6, they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And they're all going to home in on a certain spot right around there. Now this happens in general. And so here is the alternating series test. If we've got a bunch of numbers that are all positive or non-negative, and they're getting smaller and smaller and smaller, each one is smaller or equal to the one before, and if they all tend towards zero, then if you take the alternating sum, the first minus the second plus the third minus the fourth, you take that alternating series, then it automatically converges. We usually write this in terms of powers of negative 1. Negative 1 to an even power is 1. Negative 1 to an odd power is negative 1. So let's see why it works. Well, first let's look at the even partial sums. If you look at S2, that's B1 minus B2, and since B1 is bigger than B2, that's positive. S4 is that plus B3 minus B4, and B3 is bigger than B4, so that's bigger than S2. Then you add B5 and subtract B6, and you get something bigger than S4. So S2, S4, S6, S8, S10, they keep increasing. They get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and with this monotonic convergence, this is going to converge to some number. At the same time, the odd terms are getting smaller. S3 is S1 minus B2 plus B3, and B2 is bigger than B3, so this is less than S1. S5 is less than S3. S7 is less than S5. All the odd guys are getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. That's what we saw in our example. The odd guys, 1, 3, 5, 7, got smaller and smaller and smaller, while the even guys, 2, 4, 6, 8, get bigger and bigger and bigger. And finally, we have the assumption that the terms are getting, that bn is going to zero. Because the difference between an odd term and the previous even term is b2n plus 1, and that's going to zero. So these guys are getting smaller, these guys are getting bigger, these guys are getting smaller, but these guys are bigger than these guys by an amount that's shrinking. So they're coming together. This is coming up from below, this is coming down from above, and they find some spot in the middle where they agree, and that's the limit. Okay, I want to close with some examples of some alternating series. The alternating harmonic series, 1 minus a half plus a third minus a fourth, and so on, that happens to give the natural log of 2. The number we were homing in on was around 0.69, and it's natural log of 2. Another famous one is if you only use odd numbers, 1 minus a third plus a fifth minus a seventh, and so on, that gives you pi over 4. And finally, if you take 1 minus 1 plus a half minus 1 over 3 factorial plus 1 over 4 factorial minus 1 over 5 factorial, that converges to 1 over e. And if we wrote these in terms of our summation convention, the first one is minus 1 to the n plus 1 over n. The second is minus 1 to the n plus 1 over 2n minus 1. And the last one is minus 1 to the n plus 1 over n factorial.